Maryland, 21117. Please write. We found something that you can do almost anywhere. It's a lot of fun. It's definitely not fattening. And further, it seems to make folks feel good, and we'll see about it right now.
It's a big part of my life now.
It's a release.
I can do it, but I've got a lot of relatives who do it in England.
Once it gets in your blood, it's hopeless.
Just feels like a real natural kind of process.
It's a feeling of joy.
It's a way that I can stay physically fit.
Well, I love it.
I clog for the fun of it. I clog for the feeling it gives me and for the feeling it gives others. The early settlers in the southern Appalachian Mountains, most of them were from the British Isles, and they brought with them their fiddle music and their traditional dance. Step dance got removed from the tradition, the competition tradition, and began to change because it ran into other influences, and that's why American step dance is so unique. Well, step dance is the only kind of dance that I can think of where you're also a musician at the same time, and what you are is a percussionist. And the whole structuring of step dance is to make rhythmic sounds to accompany music.
The last 6 years, I've been dancing with a group out of Annapolis called the Fiddle Puppets. And we do a lot of school programs, educational programs all around the D.C., Northern Virginia, Maryland.
Step dancing that was brought to America blended here together, and the British Isles step dancing began to change due to influences of the music, rhythm, and dancing that were brought here from the continent of Africa. Some of our steps have been influenced by the dancing of the Native American tribes, the American Indians that the settlers found living here.
What equipment? You can do it barefooted. But I think the best shoe to clog in is a leather, you know, sturdy shoe, leather sole. In recent years, it's become very popular for all cloggers to wear taps. The flooring can be everything. Old floors are the best. Good old tongue and groove, you know, sprung floors are the best because, you know, it's like your drum. And music is the all of it, actually. I still really get a tug in my heart when I hear a fiddle tune. It's just always affected me that way, especially good old-time fiddling.
The kind of dancing that people can see that a lot of people can take part. You don't need a partner, you don't need extensive lessons, but just a few pointers, people can get up and take part. And it's just a real joyous experience to be out there with so many people making rhythms. Sometimes it gets a little hectic when it's real crowded, but for the most part, if you look, most people are smiling when they're clogging because it's a lot of fun to do.
And here we have three members of the Fiddle Puppet Cloggers, Rodney, Eileen, and Steve on the fiddle in the back. Yeah. Rodney, you told me an interesting thing. Where did you get your name?
Well, the name of the Fiddle Puppets comes from the fact that sometimes it feels as if our feet are attached to the hairs on Steve's fiddle bow. And when he starts playing, our feet start moving. So we're puppets to the fiddle.
What happens if you're asleep and he starts playing?
You wake up and start dancing.
All right. Now, you've played Carnegie Hall and Lincoln Center, but you have a real special program for school children. What's that like, Eileen?
We work for young audiences of Maryland, and we go through to the schools throughout the state, and it's very special work. We love it very much, and we love young audiences of Maryland.
All right, that's great. Well, Brian, come on over here.
Come over here. Come on.
Come on over here, Brian.
We'll get everybody involved.
All right. And you're going to show us how to clog a little bit.
Yeah. You ready?
All right. Yeah, I guess I'm ready. You ready?
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
I'm going to start by just stepping on your right foot. Just put your foot down and pull it back. And left foot down and back. And just do it in time. Step back, step back, step back. Come on now.
Right. Come on, Brian. Come on.
And step, step. Listen to the music.
Try these. You ready to show us some good stuff?
Yeah, that's
all right, take it.
People are interested in clogging, who would they get in touch with? Give you a breather here, too.
Well, right here in Baltimore, through the Baltimore Folk Music Society, you can learn from Bob Dassimer, and that's at the Lovely Lane Church, right in Baltimore.
22nd Street.
How long does it take to become proficient?
Depends on the person.
Oh, come on over here. I'm losing the microphone.
It just depends on the person and how much rhythm you have. But basically, with just a few simple directions, you can get just about anybody dancing within the first hour. Kind of hard to talk after having this dance for 3 minutes straight. So that's the hardest thing to do, is catching your breath. But beyond that, you already saw it. You started right out. You were doing two steps, the walking step and the chugs, right in time with us.
Steve.
Yes.
What is your enjoyment out of all of this? You're back here sitting in the back fiddling and all. How do you feel about it?
I love to fiddle. I love to fiddle a lot, and I'll tell you, I can't find a better excuse than playing for dancers.
And how often do you do this all the time? Are you on the road?
I pretty much do it every day. Now, we do programs for the young audiences in Maryland. We generally will do a whole week at a time, 3 to 4 shows a day in the schools. But I'm pretty much an obsessed fiddler, and if I can't fiddle every day, then I didn't wake up that day. You know?
That's an obsessed stash you got there. How long have you been growing that?
Well, it started about when I was 25. My hair decided it grew better downhill, and so it just sort of took to my lower lip.
That looks great. Brian, come back over here.
Yes.
They're gonna show you some stuff.
I'm gonna really get this stuff.
And take you out of this.
I'm a little bit slow, but once I get it, I know I can get it.
Well, one of the best things to do is forget about how you look. Okay. Let's do some barnyard steps, a little walking step, like step. Then you can make it like you're a chicken, flap your wings. Or if it's easier for you, you can try being a turkey. There's always a turkey everywhere you go.
Good luck to you, buddy.
All right. Okay. Okay. No.
Good job.
Oh. That's good exercise.
How you doing that? You like that?
It fits right in with what you were doing earlier. Is it good for your stomach?
You should have gotten
good for your stomach. You take that over there.
You should have gotten Sharitha McKenzie out here to do that.
Oh, yes. I'm sure she can. No problem at all.
Well, you guys are going to take us out with one, right? Since we've worn you out a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Tomorrow night, we'll have boot camp live in studio, and now we're going to take you out with the fiddle puppet
Cloggers. All right.
Rex Harrison heads an all-star cast in George Bernard Shaw's Heartbreak Hotel, Friday night at 9 on Great Performances. Now, stay tuned for The Insect Engineers on The Wild, Wild World of Animals.